Hello everybody, I'm Christian from Berlin, and this I call the perfect ballad for piano because it has a beautiful characteristic melody with just the perfect chords. So I don't have to do a lot of complicated stuff to make it sound great. It just sounds great in a simple, beautiful way. Amy Winehouse sang it, Carole King sang it, many others sang it, so it's really a ballad for many generations, and I hope you can play it after this. There's a slow replay after my small help section. It's small today because there's just not much I have to explain to you, and please enjoy it. Will you still love me tomorrow? I hope you will. Well, I'm doing the best I can. by presenting you with this great song by Carole King and Gary Goffin. And here it's a ballad. It's well playable. I believe that everybody can play it. And you just have to remember certain things. We have a left hand here that very often just goes beyond the octave, exactly one. If your hand is small and tiny, like a monkey's hand or a squirrel's hand, you can just use the pedal, let go of this, and then everybody can reach the ninth. Okay? So then we have a pattern. Everything in life has a pattern, and this one goes, usually there's a main pattern that goes like this. Dub, 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 where you can also play it without saying dub, dub, dub. And let's instead count. It's one and two and three and four. That is 90% here. And you just have to figure out the right hand. That is quite easy to play that right hand at the right moment of the left hand. That's the problem of piano playing. Okay, meaning the syncopations basically. We start with one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. See, especially, let's have a look at the first bar, because we have a lot of those eighth syncopations. One and two and three and four and. You see the problem, huh? You see the problem, but it's just a fake problem, because everybody can count, and most of you even have ears and can listen. So it's one and two and. These are called anchors, for those who are new, where they come together, and you just have to remember where they come together. One and two and three, empty, and four and. That's your job in this piece. The notes are easy. That's the job, to get the syncopations right. And if you want to get it nice and gingerly, you also do these things that are very nice in pop piano. It's worth practicing them, like this one. You know, it's these little slides, the two finger, play the first one really softly. It makes really a big part of pop piano sound when we play. You know it, you know, from recordings, and you always wonder what is that, or if somebody plays like. It's just that bit here. This is the target note that is getting the final force. May the final force be with you. And this is just a little grace note, softly, mellow, with soft finger. And then you have you are three levels up in sound just by playing one note. Then we have the same again. No, we don't have that, Christian. That's somewhere else you're dreaming. It's like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. You see, I won't do the whole piece like this. I'm just making you aware of the only complications you have here. That is really something you can get from the slow replay that is coming after this. It's like in really slow motion, where you can follow each finger. Enough of that stupidity, Christian. Now we have three moments, I believe, where we have 16th notes. Oh my God, 16th notes. Oh my God. Hell is breaking loose in your mind right now. And that is one and two and three. And now, beware. Put on your helmet, your face mask, and call the military. It's here. That's easier. One and two and three and four and. You gotta take those bars separately. and have a brief look. It's one and two and three to and four and one and two and three to and four. One more time, because it's such a fun for me. One and two and three to and four and. If you cannot play this, take a different piece. Probably choose another hobby, like ice fishing. There you don't have to make this crazy stuff. This comes back again. Then we have the B part. There's also something that where you have to do this with your fourth finger. You know, if you really can't play these slides, even after practicing for half a year, just leave them out instead of. Okay, that's my offer. That's my idea of a compromise. Then, of course, we have the B part, where I'm hunting you just a tiny bit, just so that I have some pleasure of seeing you sweat. It's like this. What do I mean? You have to jump with the fifth finger down here. It's not really far, but you have to let go. But this is a nice idea for the chorus to give it more volume, you know? And then you learn these four silly notes, F major. You see where they are and that you don't lose sight if you're moving here. You still have them in your eyes, down here. Here they are. Here they are. Of course, you have to do something in the right hand, but something easy. Octaves. Bam, 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 blah, 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 blah. You do that again. Then it is very, very important, that when you've managed the chords and the melody over it, that you try, at least you try, to get the left hand smooth and soft, while the right hand is not playing like fortissimo, but stronger. You know, it's a melody, and this is just the slave running along, the chord slave in the left hand. You know that you, in the end, you don't play it like a slot machine, like a. But. And the melody comes sotto voce. You see? Because this is actually the guitar. If you listen to Amy Winehouse recording, the guitar is playing a similar pattern, and the guitar is just, you know, comping. And the voice has to be on top, a bit more sonorous. Sonorous? No, sonorous sounds like a dinosaur. Look, Daddy, there's a sonorous. Okay, and I wish you all the best. Take care, enjoy it, and stay safe. Bye from Berlin. Thank you. I hope you liked my video and that you learned something. Now you can subscribe. Just press this subscribe button or click on another of my videos on this side. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.